big hand clap of praise on this Saturday night. Come on, everybody stand and just that can and just lift your hands and let's worship God in Jesus' name. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God above you all and in you all in one name. His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, I wish somebody would praise him. We didn't come here for a show. We came here to worship Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's praise him right now. Come on, put your hands together. Oh, I want to pray a little bit in here tonight. Go move some stuff out of here. Let's pray in the Holy Ghost. Would somebody pray in the Holy Ghost? Hey, there's some people that need deliverance from alcohol in this room tonight. Some people that need deliverance from drug addiction. Some people that are here tonight that if you're not born again of the water and of the Spirit, you're going to die and split hell wide open. And so we come here tonight to preach the gospel. We come up in here tonight to preach the truth. The death, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He's God manifest in the flesh. I wish somebody would lift up your hand and bless his name. His name is above every name. I feel the anointing here tonight. In the name of Jesus. Let's pray, let's press, let's touch the hem of his garment tonight in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There's some young people up in here playing. The world's calling your name. The spirit of the world's calling you to go right out. And you got some doubts about all of what's going on up in here tonight. But I'm going to tell you it's real. Jesus, he's the sweetest name I know. Hallelujah. It's not worshiping idols. It's not, making bones. Come on, somebody. It's not, the witch doctor and the charlatan and the shaman. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It's not the witch doctor, but it's Jesus. He's in the house. His blood has power to save and deliver. Feel the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I wish somebody would praise him right now. Hallelujah. God, I'm waiting on the Holy Ghost. Your spirit fill this room tonight, God. Remove every hindrance, every bondage.
Yes.
We rebuke every demonic spirit.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah to God. Hallelujah. There's people watching my internet. You need a miracle. You need a healing. You need a deliverance. Tonight's your night.
Yes.
Tonight's your night. There's never been a night like this night to get what you need. Can you say amen, everybody?
Amen.
How many's happy tonight? I said, how many's happy on this Saturday night? Oh, well, give your five folks a hand shake tonight, a high five. Glory. Just get out from where you're at and greet somebody tonight on this Saturday night. Praise God. Thank the Lord for being here one more time, being in this service. I want to give honor tonight to your pastor, your elder, your bishop. Amen. Elder Van Johnson and the First Lady and Sister Van Johnson, a wonderful prophetess, and all the musicians. Don't you think they're doing a good job tonight leading us in worship? Let's give the Lord a good hand clap. All the guests that are here tonight. I like what I feel tonight. How about you? If you have your Bibles tonight, turn with me to the book of Genesis. Or let's go to the book of Exodus. I'm sorry, the 14th chapter. My wife and I are glad to be here. We're from Fresno, California. I pastor the same church for 20 years, the World Harvest Pentecostal Church there in Fresno. And my wife and I have had the privilege not only of pastoring there, but preaching abroad all over Africa and Mexico and different parts of the world and many countries. And we're so glad, so honored, so humbled to be here tonight with you folks. I don't know about you, but I want the real deal. I want the real thing. And people can tell the difference between hype and somebody's personality of charisma. And then there's another thing when the anointing of the Holy Ghost comes to destroy the yokes. And I realize that through the years of Pentecost, we've had our situations and our troubles and scandalous individuals and et cetera and so forth. But it doesn't do anything to the truth of the gospel that our God is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. I thank God for the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Evidence was speaking of other tongues. I'm so grateful tonight. Amen, that his power is already moving in here. I want to tell you, I'm nothing without him. But with him, we're everything. Hallelujah. But without him, we're nothing. And we can do nothing. Hallelujah. So if you're looking to Brother Walker, I'm a nobody. But if you could just gather together in Jesus' name tonight and touch and agree, anything's possible. Hallelujah. All things are possible. Cripples walk. Blinded eyes are open. Deaf ears are unstopped. And miracles are made manifest by his power. Stand with me tonight for the reading of the word of the Lord, the book of Exodus. Chapter 14, beginning of verse 13. I want to preach tonight again on blessed to be a blessing. Some of you weren't here last night, and so we'll recap and revisit and bring you up to speed and then get right into the message of what I feel like the Lord has for us. Look at this. The Bible said, and Moses said unto the people, fear ye not. Stand still. Busyness isn't also blessedness, no. A lot of folks are busy, 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 busy working for God, but they're getting a little done for God. Because you can build a house and build it in vain if it's not built on the right foundation. If it's not built, he said, blessed are the pure in heart. God's still looking for a people of purity and holiness and consecration, a people of dedication. How many believe that? Say amen. The scripture said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you today. For the Egyptians whom you have seen today, you shall see them again no more forever. Some of you have been fighting some enemies in your life, that tonight's a night of deliverance. Tonight's a night of a redemption. Tonight's a night, amen, to be set free and say goodbye to that enemy in your life, that hindrance, that obstacle that's been holding you back. Hallelujah, that you'll never, ever have to fight that type of enemy again. I wish somebody would help me. Glory. I remember. remember as a teenager when I got the Holy Ghost in that old-fashioned tent revival under T.L. Osborne's nephew's tent. I rolled in the sawdust under the power of God and threw my addiction outside of that tent. Amen. When I was 15 years of age, hallelujah, I was bound. I was addicted. I grew up in a family of alcoholism. Amen. Tobacco, etc. Violence and so forth. But I remember the night that God set me free. And by His grace, I've never ever went back to it again. Hallelujah. There's hope. There's healing. There is a God that loves you, that died for you, that paid the price for you, and He doesn't want you to be bound in trouble and turmoil another day of your life. Woo! My God, the Holy Ghost here tonight. Whoa. You can be seated. Amen. Now, the scripture said the Lord shall fight for you. Touch somebody and tell them the Lord's fighting for you. Paul said, if God be for us, who can be against us? The Lord shall fight for you. You shall hold your peace. The Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? A lot of us think we're praying and crying, but we're just complaining, belly aching, just whining. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen, and by it the elders have obtained a good report. And we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, and Enoch had this testimony that he pleased God. The verse above it said that Abel, amen, yet dead, speaketh. Amen, yet speaketh. There's some things that's going to speak to us tonight. There's some things out of the word of God that's going to speak to us tonight. You see, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. It wasn't a second being with God. It wasn't another God with God, but God said, and God's Word has creative power. When God says something, He intends to put the earnest deposit down on it. 2,000 years ago, our God, great is a mystery of godliness, without controversy, amen, God was manifest in the flesh, seen of angels, justified in the spirit, received, preached unto the Gentiles, and received up into glory. And we understand that the fullness of the Godhead dwelleth in Him bodily. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh. God Himself, hallelujah, become a man to die on an old rugged cross. I still believe it's the blood, the spirit, and the water. I still believe in the full Bible standard of salvation. God didn't just come to save your spirit, save your soul, and let this body, amen, be riveted with the demonic forces of the devil with sickness and disease, because you and I tonight are blood-bought, blood-covenant, Jesus' name, tongue-talking, Holy Ghost-filled people that are a peculiar people. I wish somebody would say, yes. And so the scripture said that Moses cried. You'll have to excuse me, my belt broke tonight. I'm without a belt. I apologize. Please forgive me. Amen. And so scripture said, speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. Look at somebody and tell them it's time to quit crying and it's time to go forward. You see, a lot of folks in church are stuck I'm going to preach to you tonight if you let me. Can you say amen? Everybody say, go forward. Go to the book of Deuteronomy. See, I know that some of you are looking me over and trying to discern me, and just let me hide tonight, Lord, behind the silhouette of the cross. Touch my lips with coals from off that altar, and may the anointing destroy every yoke and every burden tonight to be removed, because it's not about the messenger, it's about the message, and it's about Jesus. And if it's not about him and it's about a man, hey, I didn't come here for an offering. I didn't come here for another, just another service. I came here to tell you that God is going to, amen, remove the debris that's in the well that the Philistines have filled up. And God wants to bring it all time. Book of Acts, Jesus' name, come talking. I'll run a devil, stop it. Revival, but somebody has got to open up your mind and your soul to say, Lord, it's me, oh Lord, in the need of prayer. It's me, oh God, my heart's become hard and calloused, and I've become a critical person. I rebuke critical spirits here tonight in Jesus' name. We get cynical in church. Start looking, and we start, because of past hurts and past wolves and past individuals, that we cannot, amen, discern our visitation when it comes. Tonight's an opportunity. Hallelujah. What you believe is what you're going to receive. Look at Deuteronomy, the second chapter, verse 1. Then we turn. The tide could turn tonight for your life, for your mind. Those racing thoughts, that confusion, that depression, that inner hurt and pain. Tonight, there's a Savior here with the healing balm of Gilead. The gospel's good news. Hallelujah. I said the gospel's good news. God wants somebody to repent of their sins tonight. Receive the Holy Ghost. Speak in other tongues. Be baptized into his name. Hallelujah. Be delivered spirit, soul, and body. He wants you to leave here without the chains, without the fetters. I'm telling you, God's church has been in a wilderness. It's been in a famine. It's been in a rut. It's been in a place that we don't know up from down. And people are wore out. And people are tired. Because we've heard it. We've seen it. God's wanting to bring a new touch. How many believes that? Say amen. Amen. Then we turned, took our journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. And the Lord spake unto me, and we compassed Mount Seir many days. And the Lord spake unto me, saying, ye have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn ye northward. Some of you have been going around the same mountain. Been visiting the same old same old, fighting the same old enemy, 10 feet forward and 20 feet back, not gaining any of the possessions of the land of promise, because we have forgotten who we really are. The devil is trying to make you to think that you're a nobody. The devil's trying to make you to think that you can't. The devil's trying to convince you to get your eyes on the circumstances, and to get your eyes on the hypocrite, and to get your eyes on the preacher, and to get your eyes on this and that. But I'm here to tell you, lift up your eyes a little bit higher to a higher plane. Thank you, mama. Amen. To a higher plane and look to Jesus. Behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. He's the rose of Sharon. He's the lily of the valley. He's the bright and morning star. He's the water in your wilderness. He's a cloud by day. He's a us are compassing the same territory because we're unwilling to turn. True repentance is turning and getting a holy hatred for sin. The reason why we can't have Holy Ghost revival is because we got sin in the pulpit, sin in the platform, and I'm not saying this church, sin in the pew across this nation. We got a spirit of Achan that's in the house. We want to be blessed. We want prosperity. But we don't want to live pure. And we don't want to live holy. We want to throw away the old landmarks. We want to throw away the old, amen, past. But I come by to tell you they're tried and they're true. Hallelujah. Oh, give me the old past. Give me the old past. Hallelujah. How many wants that, amen, move of God in your life? Then it's time to turn from the direction of the road that you've been on. If it's not working, why you keep doing the same old, same old? Why don't you turn and go northward? Why don't you say, I'm not going to sit down in this mully grubs, in this mess. I'm moving on. Hey, the Lord said, tell the children of Israel, go forward. You got generational curses. My mother's Italian. And my daddy came from Oklahoma in the United States. And his grandmother, his dad's mother was a full-blooded Cherokee Indian. And alcoholism ran in our family. My dad's dad did Copenhagen snuff. Drank wine and chased women. Hello. His daddy smoked cigarettes, cigars, dipped snuff, drank wine, and got in fist fights. I went to Oklahoma. My Uncle Virgil, which was my grandpa Bert Walker's daddy. Amen. Our brother, he said, you see that fellow over there? He said, yes. He said, you notice he don't got an ear. I said, no. He said, well, your grandpa got in a fight with him one night drunk and bit his ear off. Amen. And they just went at it. Oh, you ain't helping me. Generational curses. I preached on the Navajo reservations. I preached in the inner cities of America. I've been, and it ain't got nothing to do with the color of your skin or your race. It has to do with something called Adam. It's called sin. It's called rebellion. It's called disobedience. But if you want a miracle, hallelujah, turn. I said, turn or burn. Hey, you ain't helping me. I said, turn to the cross. I said, look to the brazen serpent. In the wilderness, when the children of Israel looked to the brazen serpent, it was a type and shadow of the death of Jesus Christ. You ain't helping me, but he redeemed us from the curse of the law, from the Fabian. He redeemed me from sin. He redeemed me from death. He redeemed me from disease. He delivered me from depression and oppression. And I want you to know the generational curse of alcoholism was destroyed. The buck stops here. Oh, guess what? My mama's a preacher now. Guess what? My daddy got delivered, got the Holy Ghost, baptized him in Jesus' name. Hey, 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 hey. I feel the power. You ain't helping him if the Holy Ghost is. All my brothers got the Holy Ghost. Every one of them got delivered. I'm a spirit of alcoholism. Somebody and tell them turn and go forward. Well, I'm just gonna sit here. Hallelujah. I worship Jesus right now. Oh, lift up your hands. Aren't you tired of looking at that mountain? Aren't you tired of looking at that valley? Same old, same old. Looking at the same old mountain. Looking at the same old spiritual condition that you're in. Just satisfied. I believe that he's God of more than enough. I believe that he's the God that's taken you from nowhere to a place called somewhere. But some of you between a rock and a hard spot and a hard place. But Jesus did tell the disciples, let us go over to the other side. But Sister Van Johnson, Brother Van Johnson, Elder, Prophetess, Prophetess of God, he never did tell us when we were going, let us go to the other side. He never showed us the storm. He never showed us the circumstances. He never showed us what we would go through. But he assured us that he knows how to walk on the water. And in another spot in the Word of God, he was on the back of the boat. Hey, 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 he's on your boat. You're not going under. Praise him, praise him. I don't care what the doctor said. He said you're going to die with cirrhosis of the liver. You're going to die. Oh, hepatitis. I see Jesus is right here, right now. God's touching your liver right now. Put your hands up, my dear sister. Yes, I'm talking to you. Hallelujah. I want my wife to come right now. I want you to touch her. I want you to touch her. Touching Jesus is all that really matters. He said they lay hands on the sick. Hallelujah. They shall recover. Hallelujah. Speak to you. You had a rough life. You've done a lot of things to, amen, destroy and defile the temple of the Holy Ghost. But I'm going to tell you tonight, you can finish the last lap right. You can finish the race sanctified. You can finish, hallelujah, for the master will say, well done. To the enzymes. I speak to your mind.